In this video, we're looking at a partially elastic collision between a pendulum and a cart. So we're given the mass of the pendulum bob, that's 80 grams or 0.08 kilograms. We're given the length of the pendulum, that's 1 meter. And we're given the mass of the cart that the pendulum runs into, and that's 200 grams or 0.2 kilograms. Now, ultimately, what we observe in this partially elastic collision is that the 200 gram cart is running away at 1.9 meters per second when the collision is complete, and the pendulum bob will rebound to some maximum angle that we call theta max. And we're asked a whole series of questions sort of leading up to that final conclusion. What's theta max? So in part A, we're going to look at the speed of the ball just before the impact. So that's basically what's happening in the second picture. We have the moment of impact right there. And to get the speed of that ball, we simply use energy conservation as this ball is on its way down and before the impact occurs. So we have some initial height here. That's actually 1 meter off the ground. And then all that gravitational potential energy is converted into kinetic energy by the time the pendulum bob gets to its lowest point. So we have a simple conversion of gravitational potential into kinetic energy. And we can write mgy initial is equal to 1/2 mv². The mass of the pendulum bob cancels out of this. And I can multiply both sides by 2 and take the square root of the result. And this gives me the familiar result, v equals square root 2g y initial. So we plug in the numbers. We're going to use 9.8 as an approximation for g. Y initial again is 1 meter. And that's because the pendulum starts in a completely horizontal position and it has a length of 1 meter. And when we run the numbers on this to 3 significant digits, we get 4.43 meters per second. In part B, we're asked to compute the speed of the ball just after the impact. So we already know that energy is not conserved in this collision. We were told that it's partially elastic. But what is conserved in the collision is momentum. I have a perfectly horizontal collision. There are no other horizontal forces tampering with the system. So I know that P initial is equal to P final. Now my initial speed coming into the collision, that's the speed we computed in part A, the speed of the pendulum bob just before the impact. So the initial momentum is going to be the mass of the pendulum bob, 0.08 kilograms, times its initial speed before the collision, 4.43 meters per second. And then in the final state, right after this impact, before the pendulum bob starts to rise above the ground, I have the pendulum bob moving to the left and the cart moving to the right. The rightward momentum here is the mass of the cart, 0.2 kilograms, times its final speed, which again is 1.9 meters per second after the collision. And the pendulum bob is moving to the left after the collision, so we'll just put a minus sign on that. It has a mass of 0.08, and its final speed after the collision is unknown, so that's what we're trying to solve for here. So we go ahead and solve for V final, and you can do this all at once in your calculator. Just multiply 0.08 times 4.43, subtract the product 0.2 times 1.9, and then divide by negative 0.08. And we get a final speed on the pendulum bob of 0.32 meters per second. And just a note on the signs here, we've already taken care of the fact that that pendulum bob was rebounding leftward by putting a minus sign into the momentum equation. That means V final stands for the speed of the pendulum bob, not the velocity. So we know it's moving to the left and the speed is 0.32 meters per second. In part C, we want to get the energy lost in the collision. So all we have to do is compare the energy before the collision to the energy after the collision. So we'll start by looking at the initial energy, K initial. And there's actually two ways to do this. I could look at 1/2 mv² just before the collision occurs and use the V computed in part A. But I also know that the kinetic energy in that pendulum bob just before the collision was equal to the gravitational potential energy at the beginning of the problem. So it's actually simpler to just go ahead and plug in mgy initial for the initial energy in that pendulum bob. And I have a mass of 0.08 kilograms, g is 9.8, y initial is 1 meter. This gives me 0.784 joules of initial energy. Now in the final state, I have to account for the kinetic energy in both moving objects. So I have the pendulum bob moving to the left, and I have its speed. So I'm going to do 1/2 mv². So 1/2 times 0.08 times the pendulum bob's speed just after the impact, 0.32 meters per second, all squared. And then I have the cart, which has a mass of 0.2 kilograms and a speed of 1.9 meters per second. So I do 1/2 mv² for the cart. And we smash the numbers in a calculator. And we get 0.365 joules. So how much energy was lost? We just take the initial amount and subtract the final amount. and we get 0.419 joules of energy lost in this partially elastic collision. Finally, in part D, we want to get the maximum angle the ball rises to after the impact. And we know how fast it's moving initially when it's at its lowest point. It's moving 0.32 meters per second. As it rebounds to the left, that kinetic energy is going to be converted into its final potential energy. So we know we can figure out what its maximum y value is. The tricky part of this is to relate that to the angle. So we'll just start by getting that maximum y value using energy conservation. So the kinetic energy after the impact when it's moving to the left, that's 1/2 mv squared where v is 0.32. That's all going to be converted into the gravitational potential energy in the final state when it's at that maximum angle. The m cancels out and we solve for y final, and that's v squared over 2g. We plug in the numbers. Into three significant digits, we get 0.00522 meters or 5.22 millimeters. So in the diagram, it looks like this. Y final is the height above the lowest position for the pendulum bob. How do we relate that to the angle? Well, the length of the string is 1 meter, so I'll just put a 1 there. And we can also label the length of the string when the pendulum was in its vertical configuration, and that length is still 1 meter. And then I can label the length from the top of the string down to that position y final. That length is the adjacent side of a right triangle. And that's given by the hypotenuse, that's 1, times the cosine of the angle, cosine theta max. So finally, I realized that that height, y final, is just the missing chunk right here, 1 minus 1 cosine theta max. In other words, 1 minus cosine theta max. So y final is 1 minus cosine theta max. So I get cosine theta max is 1 minus y final. We'll go ahead and plug the numbers in here. And we get 0.99478. And then to get theta max, I invert the cosine function. So I have the inverse cosine, 0.99478. And this gives me a final angle of 5.86 degrees. And we're done. If you enjoyed this video or at least found it useful, check out another one by clicking one of the links on the left, or click the Zach's Lab logo on the right to explore dozens of physics and math playlists. As always, you can leave your questions, comments, and requests in the comments section below, and I'll get back to you within 24 hours. Thanks for watching Zach's Lab, and best of luck on your math and physics journey.